I'm ashamed of you, Duncan, said Scullery. You should think of your passengers.
Passengers are just nuisances. They're always complaining. Scullery was shocked.
That's no way to talk, he said. Passengers are our gore and water. No passengers means no train. No train means no railway. Then we'd be on the scrap heap, my engine, and don't you forget it. Thank goodness Rhenius is coming home. Perhaps he will teach you some sense before it's too late.
What's Rhenius got to do with it?
Rhenius saved our railway, said Scullery.
Please, tell us about it, begged Peterson.
The year before you came, said the old engine, things were very bad. We were on our last wheels. Mr. Hugh was the driver and fireman. The thin controller was guard. He did everything else too, and helped Mr. Hugh mend this in the shed.
We expect 2 fresh engines next year, they told us, but we must keep trains going now. If we don't, our railway will close.
How awful, said Peter Sam in sympathy.
I tried hard, though I couldn't do much, but Rhenius understood.
It's my turn now, he said. You've done more than your fair share of hard work.
He was often short of steam, but he always tried to struggle to the next station, and the rest dead. That, said Scullery earnestly, is most important with passengers.
Pshaw!
Exclaimed Duncan. Passengers, Scullery continued. Don't mind stopping at stations. They can get out and walk about. That's what stations are for. But they get very cross if we stop at the wrong places, like viaducts. Then, they say we're a bad railway and never come back.
I remember Rhenius stopping in a wrong place once, said Scullery. He couldn't help it, but he made up for it afterwards. That afternoon, he had damp rails and a full train. There were passengers even in Beatrice, the guard's van. His wheels slipped dreadfully, a steep bit after the first station. But they gripped at last.
The worst over, he thought. Now we're away! Come along!
Come along, come along, he sang to the coach. Come along!
Oh! I've got cramp! He groaned.
He stopped, unable to move, on the loneliest part of the line. Then controller and Mr. Hugh examined him carefully. The passengers watched and waited. Rhenius eyed them anxiously. They looked cross. At last, the thin controller stood up.
Your valve gear on one side is jammed, he said.
We've unfastened the rods and tied them up. Now, Rhenius, he went on, we need to reach the next station. Can you pull us there on one cylinder?
I'll try, sir. But the next station isn't the right station. Will the passengers be cross?
Don't worry, smiled the thin controller. They know we can't reach the top station today.
The thin controller sanded the rails. Passengers from Beatrice pushed behind. Mr. Hugh gently eased over the regulator. The train jerked, and it began to move.
I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll do it.
Everyone cheered, but Rhenius heard nothing.
The thin controller's relying on me. If I fail, the railway will close.
It mustn't! It mustn't! I'll get there or burst!
Everything blurred. He was too tired to move another yard. But he did. And another. And another.
And another. Till I've got there at last! He sighed with relief.
It's proud of you I am indeed, said Mr. Hugh.
All Rhenius remembered about the journey down was having to go on and on. At the big station, the passengers thanked him.
We expected a long walk, they said, but you brought us home. We'll come again and bring our friends.
You're a gallant little engine, said the thin controller.
When you're rested, we will mend you ready for tomorrow.
Was Rhenius always ready for tomorrow?
Always, smiled Scullery. Whatever happened, Rhenius always pulled his trains.
It was Duncan who broke the silence.
Thank you for telling us about Rhenius, he said. I was wrong. Passengers are important after all.
All the little engines were at the wharf on the day that Rhenius came home. Some of the fat controller's engines were there too. Edward pushed Rhenius's truck to the siding, and Scullery pulled him neatly to his own rails. This was the signal for a chorus of whistles from engines large and small.
You had never heard such a noise in all your life.
But Rhenius was happiest of all, in his own place that night, next to his friend, Scullery. This helps a little engine to feel, he said,
at last he really has come home.